Hi guys, welcome back to Sleeve Saturday. You know, I just love the music of the soft rock legends Dr.Hook. The band, which formed in the late 60s under the name Dr.Hook and the Medicine Show, saw significant success in the 1970s. They shortened the name of the group to just Dr.Hook in 1975 and enjoyed album after album and hit after hit. Yet here we go again, another act that does not receive the respect it deserves from commercial radio. Just like I said in my Kenny Loggins video, I am furious how radio just dismisses acts like this that deserve so much better. Guys, this is a group who Bruce Springsteen once opened for in 1973. This is a group who sold millions of albums and changed with the times to adapt their music. From country rock in the early 1970s to disco in the late 70s, eventually circling back around to my personal favourite, soft rock and pop rock in the early 1980s, before they split in 1985. This band have a stunning legacy, and yet they are more or less focus tested off the airwaves. Once again, it's bordering on criminal by radio execs. This is a band that when you hear their songs, you think to yourself, wow, they sing that too? You know, like this one, Millionaire from 1975.
That's beautiful.
And I got more money than a horse has hairs. Cause my rich old uncle died.
The band's leaders and most famous members were Ray Sawyer, a percussionist and sometimes lead vocalist, and Dennis LeCourrier, a guitarist and bassist who sang the majority of the band's songs and their biggest hits. Ray had lost his eye in a car wreck in the 1960s, which led him to wearing an eye patch. That distinctive look lent itself to the inspiration of the group's name in the first place. The patch reminded the founding members of Captain Hook from the Peter Pan stories. Weirdly, a character that didn't have an eye patch, nor was he a doctor. It doesn't matter, along with the cowboy hat, the man's image was iconic. Physical aesthetics aside, this was a band with bags of personality and humour. Their music, with its parody elements and sometimes downright odd stage performances, straddled on self-aware comedy to borderline musical genius. They tread those thin lines perfectly. Take for example a couple of their early hits, like the ballad Sylvia's Mother from their first LP. A song about a guy trying to reach his sweetheart on the phone, but he's prevented from doing so by her disapproving mother, who wants her to continue a relationship with someone else she feels is better suited. It's such a beautiful yet heartbreaking track, and you can really feel the ill-fated desperation in LeCourrier's voice. I can't remember the last time I heard it on radio though. On their second LP in 1972, they released the single Cover of the Rolling Stone. The song, written by their writing partner Shel Silverstein, is laced with parody about how rock stars of the time got their faces on the famous magazine's cover. The stage performances of this are hilarious and couldn't be further away from Sylvia's Mother. It's absolute genius and really shows their range. Funnily enough, after the song was a hit, the publication put the band on the cover of the Rolling Stone. Ever hear it on the radio these days though? Nope, me neither.
Picture on the cover of the Rolling Stone.
Rolling Stone.
Wanna see my picture on the cover.
Stone.
Wanna buy 5 copies for my mother.
Yes. Yeah.
Wanna see my smiling face on the cover of the Rolling Stone.
Guys, the hits just kept coming in the 1970s. What about the track A Little Bit More from 1976?
And when you're by
What about the beautiful soft rock ballad Sharing the Night Together from 1978, a top 10 hit in the US?
You're looking kind of lonely, girl. Would you like someone new to talk to? Oh, yeah, alright. You'd mind sharing the night.
A year later in 1979, Dr.Hook briefly rode the disco craze with top 10 hits like When You're In Love With A Beautiful Woman and 1980's Sexy Eyes. You're getting my point here now, aren't you? What radio do to these bands is tragic.
When you're in love with a beautiful woman, it never ends.
You know that their harmonies are off the scale. This band are more than image, parody and comedy. Their songs often tell a story. Their 1975 track, The Ballad of Lucy Jordan, regales a tale better in under 4 minutes of a bored housewife with life regrets and unfulfilled dreams than entire two-hour movies or 500-page novels can do.
At the age of 37, she realized she'd never ride through Paris in a sports car.
A 1978 deep album track called Sweetest of All from the LP Pleasure and Pain tells us a story about a brief love affair, but one that both parties look upon fondly. Now, I'm not saying radio should play deep album tracks, but this one proves the depth and quality this group had. Guitars, the melodies, one catchy song after another, soft rock, pop rock, disco, country rock. Jesus, these guys are legends. The band broke up in 1985. Ray unfortunately passed away on New Year's Eve in 2018, but Dennis still tours under the name Dr.Hook, and I'm looking forward to seeing him and his band when he comes to Dublin. But besides looking at old clips on YouTube, I implore radio stations to get their heads out of their asses and embrace Dr.Hook, the band whose legacy is vast and rich. The band who Springsteen once opened for. I'm curious, guys, what is your favourite Dr.Hook song or album? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed the video. I'll see you next time.
Front smiling, man. Oh, beautiful.